sir.
Welcome back, everybody, here to the defense coverage. It is where we bring you epic games that just make you dance like a complete loony. Welcome. GDT vs. SK Gaming is our game we have. It is our last game in Group A, and it will not be our last game for the day. Luckily, there are two games left today, this one and the next one. Luckily, there's also two commentators in this broadcast, and I will welcome my Danish import. That's right. He's like a pastry. Without the coating on top of it, maybe like a bit of a sugar-coated kind of thing. Sender Man, welcome to the broadcast.
Thanks a lot. Yeah, there's more good stuff to come, and there's a lot of good players in this game as well. And hopefully we think you guys think there's a couple of good commentators in the game as well. we might make it a little doubtful now. But anyway, SK versus GDT is what it's going to be. Do you have any story about the Co9 thing, by the way? Is that
it's a new sponsor. They managed to pick up a new sponsor.
Okay. So yeah, we've got GDT on the Dire side, the Americans over there, then we've got the Danes on the Radiant side from SK. Bans pretty standard coming out here. The first pick is on the Dire side. They've banned Nightstalker as well as Prophet. Anti-Mage and Broodmother were the bans of SK. First pick Windrunner coming out of GDT, and the response from SK is going to be Lich and Tidehunter. If you're surprised, clap your hands, dance like Toby, and get exhausted and fall to the floor.
Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Well,
what's wrong with you? 10 seconds remaining.
What's up, man? What's happening? You don't challenge me with that. You don't challenge me with that. Are you right there, Sind?
Well, yeah, I'm okay.
That's good.
I was more worried for you, to be honest.
I'm good, man. I'm good. I'm just enjoying the picks and listening to your analysis of it.
It's really hard to analyze when the guy I'm commentating with is dancing and yelling all the time. Beastmaster as well as Ancient Apparition as the pickups for GDT. So they get themselves a good single target lockdown stun there. Ancient Apparition for the teamfight potential with the Ice Blast, as well as a great combination with the Roar and Shackle Shot to set up stuns for that Cold Feet. Overall, shout out to Bionut, who just asked me in a private message, what the fuck, what mushrooms did Toby eat? And that is going to be my question as well.
I eat no mushrooms.
It's even more disturbing. Anyway, Ancient Apparition was the third pick for GDT. So they've established themselves with a good solo laner. I'm expecting the AA to be played as some sort of support. Good team fight initiation from Beastmaster as well as some tankability in that one. And the Spectre is actually going to be picked as the third pick for SK. It's been a while since Spectre made it into the first drafting phase, I think.
Yeah, even in the game early today, didn't get picked up into like fourth or fifth slot. And that was just kind of like we have no other options. Where's Faceless Void? Where's all that? And they were all banned out, so they were forced to go towards Lines of Spectre. So maybe SK Pocket Strat could be coming up. Also want to just tell people there's no real reason why I'm being a bit of a twit. But this game is basically a dead rubber. The only thing this game is going to decide is who wins this game. As far as Group A goes, SK Gaming already through, so there's no pressure on them for this. They can go fun kind of stuff. So this is just a fun game. We can have some fun, Sind. That's what it's all about, funskies. I like funskies.
That's true, and the question is if SK are taking that as some sort of a test, if they want to see how it goes when you draft Spectre in the first phase because of that. Because it's not something I've seen SK doing a lot, at least, but they might also just have rethought their way of interpreting the metagame at this point. I mean, the other two picks from them are obviously dead serious and very standard. I was very surprised to see the Spectre coming off at this point, because it gives away a lot of information to the opponents when you pick it this early. They know, all right, there's going to be a weak laning hero who has to get farm, deal with it. Mm-hmm. It's like, well, what MYM did was last pick the Spectre. This time around, GDT know it earlier. I actually have the two picks remaining to try to set up some way of countering the Spectre. Is, of course, going to be hard when there's a Lich on the other side, arguably. It's going to probably run a dual lane mid with Lich Spectre, just keep denying those creeps with Sacrifice. And it's going to make it hard to actually get to the Spectre. But at least GDT know what they're up against. There's no big surprise to come now, I think, for SK. They've already shown it in the third.
Yeah, GDT is taking their sweet-ass time. Their sweet-ass time for this last pick. Maybe we just see another Husker ban. When all else fails, ban Husker. So for the people who are actually looking for something intellectual to come out of my mouth right now, my brain is...
You've come to the wrong place.
Yeah, you're kind of going to like accept the fact that this first couple of minutes for me is going to be a complete wipe. So we have Syndrin. So I have Syndrin's here.
I say some intelligible stuff now and then.
You do. A lot of the time, man. You add that professionalism, that insight, that player perspective, that complete and utter focus that would never, ever be considered to be a troll.
Oh, right.
By the way, I'm lying through my teeth right now.
Yeah, I can imagine. Meanwhile, we're back, actually. Let's go back on a little bit more professional track.
I like it. Let's do that.
Got a couple of bans coming out for GDT as well as SK to catch up on. GDT getting rid of the Shadow Shaman as well as Pugna, so two strong intel heroes that can take the solo mid-roll, which I still expect to be a dual lane from SK, though, but let's see. The Pugna and Shadow Shaman will be the ones, so no Mars Serpent wards, no pushing power, most of all, banning out heavy pushing here by GDT. And SK banning out heroes that could deal with Spectre. That's pretty much how I want to interpret those two bans.
Mm-hmm.
Faceless Void as well as Slada. Two great heroes to have against Spectre. The Amplify damage from Slada just destroys Spectre very fast. And a Faceless Void, hard hitter, hard single target lockdown hero who can catch Spectre off guard and make quick work of her, will also not be available. Oh, and I think we've had this discussion before, Toby. What gender is Spectre?
Spectre is a female.
It's female.
It is female.
Okay.
Spectre is a female. We did some research. It was extensive. Coats were lifted. And Spectre was, in fact, discovered to be a female.
Okay.
Yeah.
So a her.
It is a she.
10 seconds remaining.
I'm interested to see where the die goes from here, too. Like, what do they kind of look at to go up against Spectre? I'm thinking Weaver. I'm thinking Weaver is their last one. Just for a little bit of a couple, and that's also going to make it a little bit harder for Lich to pop off that ultimate. You jump in Shuki, and that Lich ultimate's not going to hit anything if you pop
that's
it on
true.
Weaver.
It's definitely an option. We do see Venomancer coming up for GDT, so they get the slowing power as well as lane presence there.
Team fight.
Some great team fight potential for GDT, some great team fight potential for the Radiant as well, you've got to say, now that they've picked up Enigma.
Mm-hmm.
But before we go further into this, I need to make something very important, Toby, which is a shout-out FML Big Pip and his friends, because if I do, one of his friends has to run naked around the block, so have yourself a nice time. We're back in the game again. I just had to throw out that shout-out because that sounded like a legit reason to drop a shout-out.
That's a complete legit reason. These guys are actually playing a drinking game that every single time that I freak you out or you laugh and I laugh, they have to drink. I think it's a very, very dangerous game, especially today. That's a massively dangerous game today.
And there was the final pick. Necrolite gets picked up from GDT, so that's going to be their late game response. Obviously, one of the strongest late game heroes in the game. Needs a lot of farm to get there. Needs some safeguarding, but if he's able to, he can actually handle a Spectre late game. He's almost unkillable, has the low cooldown heal, which also deals damage, has a lot buys defensive items, which give armor. He has a skill that deals percentage damage per second to all targets inside the range. So slowly but steadily kills off everyone with that aura. And that could work out very nicely for GDT here. This is going to be all about the early mid game.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm a little concerned for GDT as to how it's going to work out for them. They're going to guard the Necrolite or something. Probably going to see a Beastmaster solo mid, Windrunner offlane, and then maybe even trialaning that Necrolite if they don't do dual lane setup, which is going to be all fine for them. But once those big ultimates start kicking in from the Radiant side, the question is if GDT can hold on. When those Ravagers, Chain Frosts, Black Holes start coming in, what is their response? The only thing they have that stops the Black Hole is a Shackle Shot, a Primal Roar, or a Reaper Scythe from Necrolite. So two of those being ultimate abilities and the other one being, Shackle Shot is not long cooldown, so that's a good option.
Mm-hmm.
That's pretty much it. Cold Feet takes too long to kick in to be counted as a counter to a Black Hole. It takes way too long. The Black Hole will almost finish before he gets stunned.
Yeah.
So that's something for GDT to be worried about. Now, it's at the same time for SK, if they don't get off to a good start, they might find themselves getting locked in place by this lineup on the Dire, who have great map control with the Hawk, great global presence from the AA Ultimate, and Venomance can go in and find the ganks with Beastmaster, and just keep making the game safe for the Necrolite until he gets out of control.
Mm-hmm.
So that's going to be interesting to see. We're going to have a remake now because Versuta didn't get his ob slot.
Well done to Versuta. Fail more.
Yeah, he's almost like me. Not getting into the game on time, apparently. yeah. He's going to come in now.
Who would do that? Like, seriously, like, only a Syndra. Yeah.
And shout out to Versuta, of course.
Mm-hmm.
One of the big shoutcasters over at the Russian community.
Yeah. Actually, he's been really, really great casting a lot of the defense games while Vlad's been busy with doing the qualifiers for the Star Championship. And, well, I have no idea what has happened to...
Casper.
Yeah, I've even forgotten his name. It's been so long.
I don't know what Casper's doing.
No, I played Dota with him just the other night. he's still alive. I know that.
That's good news.
Yeah, obviously, if he was dead... we got too many broadcasters. But we do actually have one language in each one. So we've got English, Russian, French, as well as German. all inside. It's good. Right. So game will start up again once SK Gaming gets back inside the game. Also, we got a thank you from Big Pip. He's happy now that one of his friends has to run around the block naked. We want video, by the way. There must be a video posted up in the joinDOTA forums, even if it's like a horrible camera phone. It needs to be a video of that. It's got to be proof, man. Screenshot it didn't happen. actually, I want to give a big word out there to everybody, too. If you do have parties when you watch Dota, I'd actually love it if you could make a thread up on the joinDOTA forums and post pictures of your parties, just so we can see what you guys do. How do you watch Dota 2 is my question. How do you watch Dota 2? Post it up there, guys. All right, even tell the story. Like, do you get together with a whole bunch of mates, all jump on TeamSpeak, crack open a couple of beers, or if you're underage, a couple of Sprites, and and just start drinking away. I'm going to shot a Sprite, man. I'm going to shot a Sprite.
You shot? Toby, you just, I don't know, man.
Can you shot?
I'm at a loss for words once again.
Drink!
I pretty often find myself at a loss for words when I'm casting.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, good stuff.
Yeah. In the meantime, though, guys, yeah, definitely check out the forums as well. We managed to break a record 2 nights ago. Everybody jumped on the forum, so we had the most amount of people ever on the joinDOTA forums. It was great. If you don't know where it is, joinDOTA.com/forums, or there's a forums tab. You should be watching all your live streams from the joinDOTA.com website as well. you should. if you're over at O3D TV, hi to you guys as well. meanwhile, back in the game, AP mode. Let's get into it, Sin. Official shizzle game up now.
Shizzle game.
A shizzle game. That's right, Snoop Dogg. He has approved Dota 2.
This is the gizzle of the divizzle. A-izzle. On the Dizzle, we have the team GD Tizzle. And on the Rizzle, we have Eskizzle. And on Eskizzle, we have. Alright, we've got Angel playing as Enigma over on the SK side.
Hey,
Calculus.
Edgizzle?
What?
Is he Angel?
Oh, come on. I wanted to quit there because I thought it was getting far past.
No, but he's Angel. He's in the Jizzle.
Okay. Okay, Calculus will be playing Tidehunter for SK.
I'm going to try and move the camera for
Lich
this.
We've got Lich playing as the Spectre in the middle lane by the looks of it. Ryze will be handling the Lich. Miggle on his old school Lion. You've got to say it's been a long while since we've seen Miggle really rolling out with a Lion. It used to be his trademark hero back in Dota 1 when he played in MYM. His Lion was very feared at some point. I'm looking forward to seeing that. And yeah, I mentioned Angel already playing the Enigma up on that top lane. And I guess you'll give us a rundown of the American boyish.
The Americans, it is sneaking. What the hell? Sneaking playing as Windrunner. Badizzle, he'll be playing as our ancient apparition. Taku playing as Beastmaster. He is way too sexy, slithering himself around the Venomancer. And AIE owned you, also known as Valboy. It was a personal nickname I gave to him one night, this night. He'll be playing as our Necrolite to cap off the lineup. It looks like we're going to have Taku. Is he going to run top? He's going to run top, and we'll have Necrolite solo mid, which will put our tri-lane on the bottom, or at least maybe even a dual lane. Ancient Apparition, Venomancer, as well as Windrunner is our combo.
Yeah, it's going to be interesting to see the early game play out. It's the thing we always think about when there's a Spectre on one of the sides. How good a start does Spectre get? We are indeed going to see the dual lane mid coming out of SK here as predicted. Ryze as well as Link will be heading in towards that. Ryze has denied a creep up top together with Angel, so they've taken two creeps away from the top lane already to give Angel the experience up here. Little do they know that he's playing against a Beastmaster, so they probably didn't really need it. But yeah, of course, the double deny on the Radiant side can reduce a lot of the experience gain on the Dire here with Sacrifice as well as Conversion. Illusion Rune's going to go the way of Ryze, and Omegle will have a hard time.
Lions.
Probably. Maybe even not. With Tide there and with Venom moving towards the middle, he's probably going to be all right.
Actually, it's going to be fine because of that Dire ward again. Once again, GDT did the same ward. They did the same ward before to MYM. And the normal counter ward position is wrong. You don't get it because the observer ward is a little bit lower. So it's always fun to watch this little bit of a ward battle, which is going to force Calculus to use that second sentry ward as he now just realizes, crap, there is no 1 minute creep camp spawn. Where's my 30 second creep camp spawn? I'm getting nothing. Absolutely nothing. And that's going to, I think, make it a little bit harder for Miguel. I don't think he can really go on this. He's going to impale on sneaking. That's at least causing a fair chunk of damage to sneaking. I don't know if that's the setup. Yeah, it's a setup. Cackle's now going to come through the side. Gush will start this off. Sneaking's in a little bit of trouble. Doesn't have Windrun because he went first level power shot. Colfi's going to force Lion back again. So a nice play there by Ancient Apparition, who will now go one-on-one with Calculus, and that is not a fight. B-Dizzle is going to win. Meanwhile, back in the middle lane too, looks like trouble with a couple of risers in the middle lane attacking Necrolite, but he will also live in a pool of black.
Couple of risers. That's true. Yeah, he's going to be forced to use his Oh, no. Did that just happen?
What?
I think it was just a clicking bug. Never mind.
Get the living crap out of me, man. Did that just happen? Problem. What? Where's the kill? I'm not missing first blood. Now we might see it on the bottom lane. Off we go again. The Lion stun. The Gush will follow. Actually, has no mana for a Gush, so Sneaking will escape. And there goes that Colfi pushing Miguel back again. And Cackle's overextending. So SK, second attempt on the bottom lane to get themselves a kill. And, both times coming up short.
Yeah, but they're putting a lot of pressure on it at least, but Miggle is being forced to use a lot of regs. He's used two flasks as well as Tango's now. So I think Calculus even gave him his flask, and that one is used as well, but it's the same over on the GDT side. We have a trading of regen
here. They have
here.
Tangos. They have Tangos left.
There's a little bit left on both sides, but it's definitely getting drained at this moment. How's the farm looking for middle lane? Link sitting on 14, Necrolite on 8. So a good start for the Spectre, and obviously he is playing with the Lich, so we'll have more creeps to hit on.
Mm-hmm.
And it's something for GDT to handle. If Spectre gets a too good start, we know how Spectre can go.
Yeah, well, completely unstoppable, killing everything unless he goes Radiance first, at which point then you can kill him. Middle lane, in the meantime, Gale has popped off. Hello, Courier, do not go in on that. Link, Death Pulse was trying to bring him down. Necrolite almost had enough, and that one level on Heartstopper aura, well, you could kind of made him like skip a beat.
Heartstopper aura is a great ability to have when you're laning against a melee hero. Even though it's low level, you're still going to be in the range of... that was changed at some point, wasn't it? I play so rarely with Necrolite that
Damn
I actually
it!
Forgot.
I was too busy listening to you. I missed first blood in the bottom lane.
Don't worry, I missed it as well.
Cackless on the retreat. Will there be enough? Yes, there will be. I'm here. Double kill. We catch the end of it. Sneaking's going to kill me later. But it is first blood in the bottom lane.
Yeah, I'll just go check on that Necrolite thing because it's actually pretty important. And I think there was a change made at some point. Yeah, it is. The Heartstopper aura has 1,000 area of effect on all levels. So when he's just present on the lane, he kind of denies Link his regen. Of course, the Ring of Health is going to be more than Heartstopper gives, but it's still keeping pressure on them.
Mm-hmm.
They drain their hit points slowly, and it's always great to have one level in it. How much HP it drains scales per level. It's 0.5 max HP per second, and on level 4, it's 1.1.
Actually, out of curiosity for you, because I was noticing something in the middle lane before when Link popped off his salve and he got interrupted. Does the Heartstop or Aura interrupt abilities like that? Oh, no. Necrolite's in trouble. Dagger's gone, Gale as well. Cow can't get close to him. He's already popped off the Gush. And what a play by Way Too Sexy. He's holding the rest of SK back. Link comes in range of the tower. And Way Too Sexy, once again, fighting in the pitch black, will manage to live and keep his hard carry alive. I say hard carry, I mean carry.
It's a hard carry.
He's a hard. We're going to go hard?
Hard carry Necrolite, definitely. So one of the hardest carries in the game.
Soft early on, hard on later.
That's one way to put it. But yeah, great play. Good Venomous Gale there from Way Too Sexy to keep them at bay. And it's just one of those devastating slows. And if you hit two or three targets with it, it's very hard to chase for the kill. Link, even when in his Spectral Dagger, couldn't keep up with Heart, with Necrolite. I'm beginning to call him Heartstopper. That's not his name. That's just the aura.
You are now known as an ability.
Taku's going to crack level 6 top. Angel's already done that. How's that lane actually looking? Taku sitting on 21, Angel 26. So that's fairly even. Enigma should have the lead, has the lead.
Bottom lane, Miguel, trouble, Cold Feet, he gets locked. Will it be enough? They're trying to kill off Sneaking first. Power shot! Oh, Slice Impact shatters him in two. And Calculus trying to retreat. Cold Feet, Vortex, they can't slow him. Actually, they can slow him. They can't frost him, feed him up. But it does get yet another double kill for Sneaking. All four kills so far. Meanwhile, on the top lane, Beastmaster forced inside the trees. The conversions are going on a hunting spree, but they will die in the end. And Enigma has himself a couple of fans, followers. They will kill him, though. They're not a fan of Enigma. Obviously, don't like water. So Angel will bring him back around next to the tower and kill him off.
When did you get the idea that Enigma is made of water?
He's water, man.
Morphling is water. Enigma is some sort of... What's that even called? Ether? I don't know.
Ether?
Ether?
Is he ether?
He's ether.
He's ether? So he's just like a big ball of gas?
Yeah, he's that kind of guy.
Really? Jeez. We call him Mr. Methane.
An ether boy, that's my kind of guy.
he's Mr. Methane now. she'll ever be dubbed as a ball of methane gas. Meanwhile, in the mid lane, actually, I thought something was happening. It was just the courier moving forward and back. It's like, hang on, that's the third thing in the middle lane. Yeah, it's a courier. 4-0. How are we looking, actually, for our goal graph? GDT holding the advantage. It's been a little bit of up and down. A couple of bumps along the road, but we go past a 1,000 gold advantage towards GDT.
Yeah, it's pretty clear to read from the graph what's actually going on.
Well, okay. Water can die. Ethereal, gas, whatever he is, can die. Enigma is killed and split amongst GDT.
Water can die, especially if it's made of ether. But yeah, what actually is going on this gold graph that you see is that the dips we get are when the Dire get kills. Mm-hmm. When the Dire are not killing,
double kill.
Radiant out farming them. Mm-hmm. See, the graph is pretty much going up all the time, then we have a kill, then it cracks down, goes up again, kill, goes down, is on the way up again, and then it cracks down again. Mm-hmm. And that's the power of Lich and Enigma denying creeps.
That's true. Actually, Enigma's also been up on that top lane for a very, very long time now. In fact, Angel and Kalk now up here again. That's probably was the only thing that's keeping GDT Taku in play. Like, you notice GDT, he's like a 27 for 2, and that's a decent amount of farm for him, but the amount of XP which he would have lost because of those denies, that's what makes the gap.
Actually, Toby, just to end this whole thing about Enigma, I want to give a shout-out to my friend Troll CKB, who is... kind enough to quote the lore of Enigma to me in a private message. Nothing is known of Enigma's background. There are only stories and legends, most of them apocryphal. What is that? Apocryphal. Passed down through the ages. In truth, Enigma is a mystery for whom the only true biography is description. He's a universal force, a consumer of worlds. He is a being of the void, at times corporeal, other times ethereal.
Right.
So he's water when you want him to be, and he's aether when I say so.
I love it! We're going to watch the middle lane go down in the meantime. Necrolite, the false ghost. Calculus might lose his life because this Way Too Sexy got a couple of good hits off. It's not going to be enough, though. And I'm glad we can officially finally put it to rest of... AA ulti. Watch the ulti. Watch Calc. Life. Is it... Oh, it's enough! Shatter.
Wait,
shatter.
Did it hit?
Shatter!
It hit!
Shatter!
He cracked it with crack.
Shatter! What? Did
calm
he?
Calm down! He's not affected!
Damn it! It's the ice armor that was screwing with me! I don't know what it is anymore! Is it ice? Is it water? Is it ethereal? I don't know!
I don't understand my world anymore!
I don't understand my shatter!
That's going to be another kill for SK, though, up in the top lane. Miggle allied with Angel up there to get that kill and the tower. And now we're going to see a change in that gold graph in just a moment. All right, the Dire did get the bottom tower as well, so maybe not. It seems like it's actually a trade-off. That bottom lane for the Dire has worked out very well, and because of that, Sneaking is in a very good position. Face boots, almost hood at 10 minutes here, and he's looking for a Shackle and Link if he can find an opening.
Mm-hmm.
He's probably going to get it now.
There goes the Gale. Beastmaster Roar. Cold Feet needs to combo. There's the AA ulti. That one does hit. There's no Kraken Shell for that. And Link, will he? Yes, he does. They don't want to wait for the Shadow, so they just basically pump him with an arrow.
Mega kill for Sneaking at 10. It's looking very strong on that Windrunner. And an important kill for GDT as well. Of course, have to bring down that Spectre and deny her the farm. Link already with the Vanguard and boots at 10 now. So he's looking very good. But it is also going to cost them a tower by the looks
of it. And the top lane. Angel just soloed Necrolite with a black hole. It's like, what the hell are those guys?
Speaking of important kills.
Necrolite dying, black hole. I mean, Enigma getting it. That being thing. Damn it, now Enigma is just so much more of a mystery. Maybe he's even a code. Oh, I couldn't help that one, man. Sorry. I apologize. I apologize. I really shouldn't have gone there. Hey, you're right. They're smoked up and they started blasting them again.
I just love tabbing out to the chat every now and then and just comment. Toby needs medical help.
Thanks, guys. Thanks. I'm not crazy. I'm not crazy. My mother had me tested. I'm eccentric, damn it. I'm eccentric. It's what I try to tell myself before I sleep every night. Set up in middle lane. It looks like they want to go for Link again.
At a loss for words again. You go.
They're setting up. Beastmaster Roar's going to set this up. He can't. He's got to work his way through the trees. Roar goes. Windrunner gets in position for a Shackle. AA ulti combo holding. Power shot. Will get the kill. Dunskies. In fact, he gets split. No, four heroes were there, and not a single one of them can get the last hit. Go figure. Top lane. SK is still looking for another kill. They might even look for a straggler. Way too sexy, but walk past the Radiant Ward, so SK do know where he is. In fact, he's going to walk up towards the top rune and then walk into the entire SK side. That was not part of the plan, Stan.
It's going to bring Calculus close to level 6 on the Tidehunter, which is, of course, a very important mark for SK to reach. Getting that Ravage up is always the most important thing with Tide. It's the strong part of the hero is his ultimate. Has to get up towards that. He's
top
still level
lane.
5, but against
trouble, trouble, stun. There goes a bigger one. Double impale as well as big finger into Necrolite. Hey, Aldi will pop, and this should be the death of Miguel, so it will be a trade-off. And Ancient Apparition, it does cause the shatter. And Angel will TP himself back out again. Meanwhile, back at Sindarin's wise words.
Worth noting is how much farm Angel is actually getting as well, and that Enigma is sitting on 69 CS, has the highest farm in the game. 2-1, has a Hood of Defiance already, as well as that Soul Ring and Boots. So he's keeping up a good pace and building towards a pipe by the looks of it, so he can keep his team alive from the magical damage combo and the Dire. That's the thing you always need to consider when you pick Necrolite. He is a hard carry, but the biggest part of his damage is magical.
Mm-hmm.
Unlike pretty much every other carry in the game who has mostly physical damage. Arguably, Tinker is actually a hard carry as well if you look at it that way, and he has magical too, and pure damage on the laser. But technically, Tinker and Necrolite are probably the two only non-hard-hitting hard carries in the game, in my opinion.
But that's why you make him unkillable. That's why he's looking to complete up a mech. He's already got the buckler for it. Headdress can follow. Couple of nulls. Looking hunky-dory for mana. And they can just keep on pulsing. Everyone will stay alive. And with Windrunner with the pipe, which is almost done too, then, yeah, you're looking even better. In fact, we've got a courier flying out now with a stout shield. Are we going to go Vanguard or something? Beastmaster might have his Vanguard done. Yeah.
No, he's got 54 CS and one death, so that seems reasonable to have at this point. 14 minutes in. GDT really trying to take the fight to SK now. Want to fight for this top tier 1. SK pushing the bottom tower right now with Angel as well as Calculus. They're both going to TP up and prepare though, and they have their big ultimates ready. This could be disastrous for GDT if they don't see this coming now.
Well, they can. The Hawk is sitting at the back end. They know exactly what's going on. Now the TP will come, and they will just fall themselves back. There's support coming up. Way too sexy and Taku coming up from the river. They won't want to go down for that, but they were thinking about the middle lane where Link already is. So the TP now comes in from Windrunner to stop Link from going down the middle. And then the conversions are pushing on the tier one tower on the bottom lane. It's happening in all three lanes.
A lot of good pushing and pressure coming out from both teams here. It's kind of hard to say who's in the lead right now. The Gold Graph still saying GDT, but it's rising.
Taku. Oh, I kind of thought the dagger was going to fly, but the support wasn't close enough. My bad.
Seemed like they're a little bit far away. Calculus low on mana as well on his Tidehunter. Can't really get the job done if he finds an opening. He doesn't have the mana to pop the Ravage.
He doesn't. Well, he has a stick charger, so he can get the mana back faster.
Oh, he does. Okay. Yeah, he has 10 sticks. That's true.
Yep. So it shouldn't be too bad. But once again, Enigma on the top lane. Even if he doesn't stay up here, the Convergence are going to push this tier 2 tower and deal. If the tower's already down half life. Yeah, Angel's going to TP out and leave the Convergence to do the rest.
The current game situation, though, which is GDT having taken the bottom and mid tier ones, is what's giving this situation on the map right now, which is GDT moving aggressively around here. And SK on the back foot. They're standing everyone inside their own base. And GDT basically have two open jungles right now that they can farm because SK are not going for anything right now. Mm-hmm. And if they realize this, they could be farming the entire woods area for both sides.
They're going to go for Ancient Apparition. He vortexes the slowdown Angel. It's a nice shackle holding Miguel in place. AA might just pop the ultimate off considering he's going to die. Yeah, he will do so. Flying on and hits Miguel. But that is all he can do.
And that is going to give SK some position back on the map.
It's also going to give Angel almost enough for a Blink Dagger. Or a Pipe if he does complete that first.
Which gold does he have?
He's got 1660. I'm wondering if he goes Blink or Pipe.
Knowing Angel, I think he's going to go for the Blink here. But I'm not sure it's the best choice. But I think it will be his choice.
Well, considering they got a couple of ganks on... Well, actually, how many times has Ancient Apparition died? Only once. Actually, that's his first death. Props to him. I'm just wondering if he thinks he can pick up the Ancient Apparition or Necrolite in the Black Hole, then the Pipe, there's not much real need for it. The only problem is BKB, the Roar from Beastmaster is going to stop that Shackle as well. So he misses out on the stun. It's kind of a six of one, half a dozen of the other.
And Windrunner, who got the top tower actually, last hit went to Beastmaster. So another tower goes down for the way of GDT, and they're building their map control right now. SK is still farming better, but if they keep losing towers and get cornered, then eventually they can't do it. Mm-hmm. Calculus spots out Snaking up at the top. Snaking is still trying to push this one in. And, until the other SK heroes show up, he's going to be just fine, because Calculus obviously can't deal with Windrunner alone. He's just trying to push this out, and they're dealing a significant blow to that tier 2 base tower. Tier 2 outer tower there for SK. Almost down to half health now. And all the while, Necrolite free farming the forest. We've got heroes farming the middle lane. And a Link is the only farming hero for SK at the moment, farming the bottom lane, as Angel now takes over the top lane.
Just thinking, there's the Blink. Is he supposed to be sneaking or snaking?
Snaking.
It is meant to be snaking. No wonder he's been ripping on me for not saying his name correctly.
Shout out to Anonym6118 for telling me that. I also would have called him sneaking as well.
Yeah, it looks like sneaking.
It does. And it's... Which is pretty... No, it would be better if he was playing a stealthy hero and was called sneaking. That would be nice.
SA. Yeah.
SA played by sneaking. That's some...
That's the shizzle.
Good shit right here. But he is Windrunner, so not going to happen this game. He's doing a tremendous job at his Windrunner, though. 5-0 too.
So now the push to the tier 2 tower.
They keep the pressure on. Is that a mech up on Necrolite?
Look at Angel.
Yes, it is.
Look, why did he already use his Midnight Pulse? I don't think he meant to do that. He used it on the wall. Did he use it? No, he used it to clear the trees. Now he's going to blink in! Whoa! Huge black hole! Then the Ravage! SK! GDT! They need to pop the pipe back. Lich only bouncing around. It's doing nothing to GDT now. That's all that life came back. Link getting BK roared up here by the Taku. Metamancer pops his ultimate. Link will go down. Rise on the fall back. GDT! How are they alive? What?
They got 5 heroes in Black Hole, 5 in Ravage, 5 in Chain Frost, and they lose the fight 0-3!
That's bullshit!
You're kidding me!
It's the mech! It was the mech and Death Pulse.
happening
to me? The mech and Death Pulse was it.
Mech, Death Pulse, and the fact that Windrunner flew in the pipe just before the fight started was...
GDT.
I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like that. Not in Dota 2, at least.
Put that one down to the textbooks, guys. That one down to the textbooks. I thought this game was going to be like, meh, 4GL, but it wasn't. It wasn't at all. It's a dead rubber, but it's just given us one hell of a combo and one hell of a,
I'm still dumbfounded by this. Or actually, I'm not dumbfounded, because I was talking quite a lot about it. What the fuck?
WTF, the only thing that can be said after that.
That's some serious shit right there. That's
Hypnotoad, the pipe didn't do nothing. The Lich Alderman bounced around at the very, very end, and it had no effect on GDT. It was the Enigma Black Hole to the Ravage, and they came back out. The Death Pulse pipe then went off. Everybody got life back again, and because the pipe popped off at the very, very end, they couldn't deal any finishing blows to any member of GDT. And the maybe that was a big thing as well. There was no Midnight Pulse.
Obviously, the Midnight Pulse would have done the trick there, probably, at least. But
the time for casting that was...
Exactly. Then he wouldn't have caught everyone in the hole. He might even have got roared if he had tried to cast that.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
I can't wait until it happens, because I know Ice Frog is going to implement it. But he's going to make it so you can go back in time. And I'm just going to find the replay of this game and just keep on watching the same fight at, maybe... 0.01 of the speed of what that fight was supposed to be.
This sort of slow motion feature would be really cool.
Yeah.
Oh, he was probably made of aether at that point.
Oh, stop it, Sin. Stop it. In the meantime, GDT, they're gonna pick up Roshan. oh, I'm gonna have a drink, Sid.
It's gonna be a Roshan for GDT.
They can't stop it. There's no ward looking at it, and the dire GDT. There's one good thing from GDT. I notice a lot whenever they play their games. They're always about keeping whatever they're doing secret. There's always sentries, there's always observers, they always want to keep the vision, they always want to have the advantage. It costs them a bit when they do it, but considering they have the advance, snaking, was looking for a shackle, he's not going to get it, but considering they have almost a 7,000, actually it's a 7k advantage almost, in gold, they can spend the money on wards.
One thing we haven't talked about yet, imagine being SK now after that fight. How do you go from there?
What?
When you feel like you've hit everything on the spot and you lose the fight 0-3, how do you go from there?
I don't know, man. Maybe they're just thinking, you know what, Radiance, that'll do the job. They've almost got it on Link too. Like, he's only 300 gold, and this is their answer. Push down mid, take a tower. There's so many tier 1 towers, but they're going to lose a tier 2 tower in trade, and GDT won't stop. They'll keep pushing. AA ulti is going to stop this push as well. And there goes the pipe from Angel. That's kind of needed to come a little bit later.
I think GDT are just going to be so confident now after that fight that they feel like they own the world right now.
Mm-hmm. In fact, they were about to own the tier 3 tower in the bottom lane. In they go. Venomancer starts up his ward of war. A freaking wall of wards. Plague wards. These are little
suckers. Water wall.
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah. A
wonder
wall.
GDT still doing the damage. I mean, even down on the low ground, they can keep doing this. No creep wave spawns, and the second it does, they'll get destroyed by the Death Balls. And the Aegis Immortal is also on the Necrolite. Angel wants in. Angel so wants in, but he also doesn't want to be shackled like he is. Power shot as well as the ulti, and Lich Alderman will bounce around GDT. It's almost enough to kill up the Necrolite. In fact, it is, but that's why they invented Aegis Immortals. Link on the front lines with a Relic. It's his damage which is doing it. Then the Ravage will pop from Cataclysm. Aegis match as well. Then the triple stun as well from the Impale from Lion. Will it be enough? Spectre goes down. He drops the scythe right through the middle of his head. Wasibe, freaking raise your head, kind of. What the hell is it? I can't remember the name of that thing. Melee backs will go down, and GDT keep 5 up. This, I would have to say, Syndrome is GG.
It's as close as it gets, at least. The advantage that GDT have built over the last 5 minutes is unbelievable on the back of that fight they just had. Mm-hmm. Again, a great initiation coming out of SK here. They didn't get the black hole, though, because of a fantastic shackle shot from Snaking. But the rest of the stuff they used was spot on. They hit everything. They did kill Necrolyte, the only one. He has the Aegis. Mm-hmm. Pops up again, heals everyone up to full life again, and they're just going to continue on this tier 3 now. And SK are going to struggle to hold on. They're probably going to might get a kill on the exit here. But they will lose the tier 3 for it,
That's going to be trouble for him. Necrolyte's in trouble. He's leaping around as a frog, but there goes the mech charge again. Tier 3 tower's gone. Angel's letting the sun off on Snaking. But GDT will retreat. They've had enough. They've got a tier 3 tower at the bottom racks. So,
I know, this is really, really surprising to me, I've got to say. How everything is going right now. I don't know. It's really cool to see. I know the power of mech. I know the power of pipe. And of having a Necrolyte. But when you land everything perfectly in a fight like that...
You still can't get over it, can you?
They still didn't kill one.
You still can't get over it.
it certainly is something to think about. Because obviously... If SK had the AA, this would be no problem at all, because then they could lock down all the heal.
Mm-hmm.
That one is on GDT's side, which is why they are feeling confident picking Necrolyte, because it doesn't get countered here. It's just working out so nicely for them right now. And it's all because, I guess you could say it's because Spectre at this point is not getting strong enough yet. Yeah. It's what we were talking about. GDT's job here is to prevent Spectre from getting strong enough early on. Spectre got some farm, but never reached the core items. I'm starting to think that if Spectre would have gone for Diffusal instead of trying to get the Radiance, they might have had these fights on that little edge that they lost them with. Maybe Diffusal could have done the trick.
Maybe it could have, but this is the way they're going to go. But they are getting a couple of items up, so we've got Blink Dagger now coming up on Lion, and the Radiance is completed on Spectre. So we've got the Flying Courier sending that in now.
It's their last chance as well. If they lose another side, the game is over.
Yep, and GDT are looking to make it their way. They're smoking and running down the mid, heading for a kill. And they can actually run straight into the base as well. SK, though, have smoked up as well. We can see a smock on schmock, hot as schmock, waiting for the middle lane. But actually, Raiden got the advantage. They got themselves a sentry ward. They got a sentry ward down the middle, so if AA comes in... In fact, AA is now going to realize it too. If the creep wave starts attacking him, Power Shot will go. They know what's there. They drop their own sentry ward. Angel starts up with a stun. Beastmaster won't do the roar. He does do so on Angel. AA will fly as well. Good Ravage. Black Hole should follow. Good stun. Necrolyte's gone. They've lost the mech and heal. The Chomper's going to bounce. It's bad for GDT. Snaking caught it a little bit too close. Then a man to try and retreat back out again, but it's hard to run as a frog, and he's still going to get done down. The Cold Fiend trying to hold Cactus in place. Miguel blinks up. They get the stun. They want another. It is an ultra kill. Link gets four. He wants to get Snaking. He is on the run, running on the line of the dagger, but he will not be able to do so. Ultra kill and force the Necrolyte buyback.
And GDT getting a little overconfident here with the position. Oh, well, I guess you can't even say that because it worked out so well the last times. But position-wise, the problem here is that they're lacking the Aegis.
Mm-hmm.
In contrast to the last time they base pushed. Getting inside the base like this without the Aegis, I was about to say I'm actually a little surprised GDT wanted to rush it like that. They could wait for the next Aegis, try to get that, and then try to play it a little bit more safe. They were confident enough going in, and this has got them something to think about. It's actually Link getting a quad kill there on Spectre. What does he get from that? What's his new item? Is he going to get one yet?
He's still got the 2k gold. Phase boost, and that's it. Blink, Angel going Taku, Miguel, the roar is up. Taku still held in place. Angel's also there. The gale will pop. AL is going to fly in, but the pipe is already up, so there will be no effect. Or maybe there will be. Sneaking comes in a little bit closer. I mean, freaking Snaking. Cackless, trouble. The side is dropped. Shackle shot doesn't manage to latch Link to anything. And there goes a power shot. There's a good power shot right through the back of Tidehunter. That's not ethereal. That's a rump. That is staked. And now GDT will go through the main base. The wards get dropped down. Angel doesn't have his black hole just yet. And because he got attacked, the Blink Dagger keeps on going on cooldown, so he can't get closer. And GDT will fall back with no Beastmaster.
Yeah, and what GDT must be thinking right there, just going in immediately, was that, all right, now all the Radiant Ultimates are on cooldown, we've got a good shot at it. And they did, but losing a hero like that and having a rebuy on the other end, two rebuys, right? Yeah, Enigma and Tide rebought. So they got a really good trade for that, no doubt about it, but they couldn't get in. Without the Beastmaster, the 4-on-5 situation, they don't dare that, even knowing that Ravage and Chainfrost and Black Hole are down, they're still not going to go for it. And I've got to say, it's the right decision. Maybe should have waited a little bit on the Beastmaster engage there until everyone was there. But SK scrambling their defense, and they get it, and they're still in this.
Can you help me with this decision? We got a Vlad's on Venomancer with a team that has 4 ranged heroes.
Plus 5 armor to all heroes. Plus 15% damage aura. Pretty good.
Figure out that. Like, Taka's the only one that's actually making the most of lifesteal.
It's a common misunderstanding on Vladimir. Some people say it's only worth it if you have melee heroes. I disagree. I think it's a good item even if you have none.
Really? Just because of the aura stack?
It costs 2,050 gold. It gives 5 armor to every hero on your team. That's a chainmail for all heroes at a price that is lower than chainmail. You get 15% damage aura, mana regen aura, and
man,
HP regen.
Man,
to the
watch the courier! Character. Watch the courier! Death Boss was following the courier.
It's a really underrated item, in my opinion. It's great to have this item. Mm-hmm. And, the 5 armor aura, it's the same as a Kiras. The positive aura for your team is just as good as a Kiras. Mm-hmm. At the 1/3 of the price.
Bargain! Bargain!
It's a good price. I've got to say, it's nice.
Mm-hmm. I even liked how that rhymed. You should go back to your poetry again, man. I think they're waiting for Roshan to respawn right now. So maybe they are listening to your advice and wait for Roshan, get the Aegis, and then push. Because if they take a second barracks and SK, well, actually, then, no, they still have enough to hold off. I'm wondering if Spectre, if he does go up with what I'm assuming is going to be a heart. That's what I'm assuming from Link. Now he has the 3200 and heads in towards the secret shop. I'm thinking we're going to see a Reaver. He's just going to go for the try and kill me if you can. Yep, yeah. Reaver.
There it is.
It's Reavers. Reavers.
Actually, an interesting question coming in from the chat. Can you check if Beedis has been in every kill? He's been in 15 out of 16 on Ancient Apparition. Windrun has been in 14 out of 16. And then respectively, Beastmaster 10, Venno 10, and Necrolite 8. So Windrunner and AA have just been all over this game. Really impressive performance by them. In the lane as well. Got all those kills.
You kind of got to say, though, as Ancient Apparition, it's easy to be part of every single kill due to his ultimate.
As well as
his Vortex.
It's never easy.
I suppose it's easy when GDT just fights as 5. Always fights as 5.
It makes it easier. I'll agree with that. But it's never easy to be in every kill in the game.
He's missed one. Damn you, Beedizzle. Yeah. Roshan's up now.
Yeah.
Set up, starting.
This is going to be the deciding fight. I dare say that if SK take this one convincingly, they're going to win the game. If GDT take it, the game is over.
Yep.
And if it goes even, nothing is decided yet.
The funny thing is, they can actually do this because of the Vlads.
I was about to say, that's a useful thing about having the Vlads right here. Because now Beastmaster can actually do it on his own, pretty much.
Mm-hmm.
Windrunner's going to help out with the focus fire here. SK are way on their back foot. They probably realize it now, but it's going to be too late.
Yeah, there's a conversion going in.
They're going to be too late.
Yep, Roshan's gone. There is nothing they can do about it. The illusions will catch him. And that is it, but Roshan is gone. Nikolai picks up the Aegis.
He's got a Hex in 500 gold.
He's got it. He's hanging inside the Rosh pit so he can buy it. There we go. All in.
Double scythe, one on Windrunner, one on Necrolite. Boots of Travel on Beastmaster. He's got plate mail as well as cloak.
They're getting
really beefy on the Dire side. They just want to survive this combo. They know that if they survive the combo, they're going to win the fight.
Just realized too, this is a 7v5. Taku can buy back and then BT in. Including the Aegis Immortal from Necrolite. Taku just has enough money if he dies, and now he's getting these conversions. He definitely has enough money if he dies to
they're
buy back.
Getting themselves in a good position now, GDT.
Yeah.
But it's still winnable for SK.
Look for that ulti combo. If they kill off Necrolite and then pick off a couple support heroes before Necrolite comes back alive, it's a 3-4 second opening. That's it. That's hard. Focus fire now from Windrunner going on the melee barracks. Hackless is being forced to come up a little bit closer. And sneaking just starts again. Lich, Frost, and Rassman forcing them back. Kalkwan's in. He also wants to pop off, though. He doesn't want to get shackled to a creep. This could be the death. He needs to ravage. He needs to ravage. Ravage now. Black hole combo as well. Aeoni will not hit anything. It flew over. The Lich Ultimate is definitely going to hit on GDT. But Akarai is in the middle of a death pulse as well as the mech charge. Angel is forced back. He will go down. Angel is dead. Enigma's on the sidelines. Link trying to retreat back out again. Reaver will not save you from a Beastmaster as well as the rest of the team. Death pulse gets the kill. Spectre is gone. Does he have enough to buy back? No, he does not. This is the mid barracks gone. This is going to be a big thing for GDT. And it looks like it comes down to whoever has the Aegis wins, and that Aegis is still there, Sind.
Yeah, this is it. This is the game. They can take Mega Creeps now. They're going to go for the top lane. All ultimates on the Radiant side are blown, and they didn't even take a kill from it. So even if they all come out and take the fight, they're going to lose it anyway.
Mm-hmm. So it's a consolation prize for GDT. We've got to give them props. They have they've played their hearts out for this one, so they will end at 2-3. It will be the same stats as Meet Your Makers. But the people who will go through is at 3-2-3-2. SK and Problem will advance in second and third position, and MTW take number one. But this is GG, well played. I still think GDT should be happy with what they managed to pull off for this game. Still maybe go back to the whole decision-making about pushing in without Nagus for the second time. Giving a possibility to SK. But they played it nicely. SK still looking for a couple of collateral kills. And they're going to get one on snaking. But they're going to lose the rest of their guys in the tier 4 towers. Oh, Sind.
I just got to say, I'm really surprised with this performance. I mean, to me, GDT has just stepped up a notch. Mm-hmm. from what we usually see from them, this was really, really good. And it doesn't go to say that GDT isn't a good team. They've always been a good team, but this was just a level above. I'm sure you agree with that. You've cast a lot of their games.
Yeah.
And this was a totally different GDT than we saw against MYM earlier today.
Mm-hmm.
Much more coordinated, much more playing as a team. Have a strategy, have a game plan, follow it through, and get the job done. They were more scattered, doing more random things against MYM. This was really coordinated, so taking down SK is no easy feat. It was a really impressive performance here.
Yeah, I want to give big props to them. GDT have really performed well. I'm looking forward to them in a couple of tournaments coming up as well. We obviously have a couple planned here at joinDOTA, so you guys can check all that out. Of course, definitely do keep on checking out the next stages of the defense. We have our last matches for Group B going off tomorrow, and that's going to find out if we're going to have ourselves a three-way tie in playoff matches. Same with our matches later on tonight. And, of course, with our next match coming up, which is Infuse versus SGC, if Infuse take that, they go to 3-2 in Group D, and that means Mouse Sports is a must-win game for them for the first game tomorrow. If they don't win that game, they will be out, and Infuse will be through in the top three slots. And if both those teams win it, we still will go to a playoff game to see who will take the third slot to advance to the second group stage. So really, a lot more action coming up tomorrow, but we still have one more match tonight, Infuse versus SGC. I love how SK are actually still fighting this one out. They've actually got themselves a fair few kills, but you can't hold up against Mega Creeps. Not at this stage.
Early in the game anyway.
Yeah.
That would be... It would be completely ridiculously epic if it happened.
Yeah. Yeah, it would...
but not gonna happen.
It's... Just look at the way they make... How long the Mega Creeps will die at take to kill at the fountain. They're having to spam spells inside their own fountain to kill off this Mega Creep army. Because even the fountain doesn't deal that much damage to them. And then the next wave comes in. This is... Yeah. There's still props to SK, they're holding on. But it is GG. It is so GG. Last tier 4 tower's about to die. There's no way this is not GG, is it? we've had moments before where we've gone, this is GG. This is over. Completely over. And then all of a sudden, holy crap, what the hell's going on? Even Miguel trying to... Oh, that's got the kill on Ryze. And then the roar. Yeah, this is GG. I'm just double checking. It's never a good thing when you go premature. Even Taku living through the finger of Miguel. And Angel holding Venno in place just long enough for Angel to get the last hit. But there's too many. The Creep Wave's attacking the fortress and we will get our official finish. What is Link looking for? He's looking for Taku. In fact, he gets it. The Haunted Illusion kills off Taku. But that is GG. And the Aioli just flies over. Go that TP. Look at that ring spin. You spin me round, baby, right catapult.
Oh, that looks pretty cool.
It does. Right next to Spectre as well. Yeah. But that is GG. SK Gaming. They lose to GDT, but they will still advance in the group stage, to second group stage. Of course, stay tuned. One more game. All we have left for you tonight, Infused up against SGC.
I said good day, sir!